Hi, I'm Matt Ablock from Mobile World Live. Welcome to Las Vegas, Nevada for day number 3 of CES 2013. The highlight today was a fantastic keynote from Samsung and also an appearance by former President Bill Clinton.
The electronics industry has been fortunate. Global consumers have eagerly adopted our mobile technologies and welcomed new advances. Right now, there are more than 6 billion mobile devices in use. And last year alone, over 500 million smartphones were sold. We have leveraged the benefits of Exynos 4 Quad and Exynos 5 Duo to create the next breakthrough for our Exynos lineup, the Exynos 5 Octa. The Exynos 5 Octa introduces a whole new concept in processing architecture.
We're so confident about the market potential of flexible OLEDs, we're creating an entire new line of them under the Yume brand name. Take a look at this flexible OLED prototype. Our team was able to make a high-resolution display on extremely thin plastic, so instead of glass, so it won't break even if it's dropped, and we can actually bend the screen. Have a look at this bended Yume prototype device. Do you see how the screen curves beyond the edge of the display around here? With this bended display, we have expanded the canvas available for content. Content can now flow along the sides of the device. So, for example, if I receive an important message, I can see it come through while the device is flat on the table in front of me.
Please welcome founder of the William J. Clinton Foundation and 42nd President of the United States, President Bill Clinton.
I'm here with Jeff Blaber from CCS Insight. Jeff, welcome. You were at the Samsung keynote this morning. Were you impressed?
Very much so. They told a story that you don't often hear directly from Samsung itself, and that's the fact that, you know, a big part of their success is the control of the supply chain, and by that you mean the processor, you know, memory, screens, display. You know, it's giving them a huge advantage in terms of scale and supply, and you know, they told that story well.
And on the processor side, they launched the 8-core Octa. How powerful is this going to be?
So I think it's a significant step forward. It's based on ARM's Big Little architecture, which we've heard a lot about, but not necessarily seen implemented commercially yet. So it's a huge step forward in terms of power.
I think the thing that got the most whooping in the audience was the displays. They were showing the fold around displays.
Yeah. This was a prototype, but I think that the important thing to take away from what we saw today was that you know, they showed a working prototype. So it was impressive. I'd still argue that this is at least probably a good year out in terms of seeing something that's, you know, really commercially viable and that's going to start to drive some volume. But when you consider the market today, and differentiation is very, very difficult for manufacturers, it's all about big slabs of screen. There's a very strong argument that this is the next big differentiator, and it's disruptive. This will worry Samsung's competitors.
We're announcing today that we're moving to free up a substantial amount of spectrum for Wi-Fi to relieve Wi-Fi congestion and improve Wi-Fi speeds at conferences and airports and ultimately in people's homes. And this is an exciting new initiative for us, working closely with Congress on this and obviously other government agencies. But this is really important, or we're going to run into a Wi-Fi wall the way we're at risk of running into a licensed mobile wall.
So we just saw an interesting announcement there from the FCC regarding the use of unlicensed Wi-Fi sticks. But there was another unexpected moment during his speech.
This is hugely big, important, wonderful news. Could you hold on, please? Sir, could you hold on, please? We have a First Amendment here, but could the audience applaud the chairman for this great announcement, please? Thank you very much.
And you know it, people are suffering.
Okay. So, with that great announcement that was interrupted by one exuberant person, thank you very much, and I apologize.
So that just about wraps things up for day three of CES 2013. And what a fantastic day it's been. We'll see you tomorrow for more. My name's Matt Ablott at Mobile World Live.